Yeah, I know what you're saying. You're probably thinking, oh no, it's a Pokemon toy. He's doing Pokemon toys. Why? I wish you'd do more robots. And you know, this is actually kind of fun. Now, I'm not a huge Pokemon fan anymore. I'm really not. It's been many years since I've played even one of the games, and those are really the only things I actually liked from Pokemon. The cartoon was okay, but the games is where all the fun was at for me regarding Pokemon. However, I saw this. Saw it on the interwebs, and I liked it. I thought it looked pretty interesting, pretty nifty, and I had some plans for it automatically right away. Just ooh. Just promise I've never seen one in stores. Well, recently Amazon had this for about $8, but it comes packaged in this little box. This is from the Pokemon Diamond and Pearl collection. Or I'm calling it collection. Maybe it's a subline. Maybe it's an actual toy. I don't know. This is a Pokemon vehicle, if you could not tell. And it is the Meowth balloon. And what a balloon it is. Now, for as long as I was watching the cartoon, back in middle school, I guess it was. It's been a while, apparently. Team Rocket would travel via this balloon. And then I think at some point they did move up to the Magikarp sub, which, yes, I'm very tempted to get it as well. But this would be how they got around. This is the Meowth balloon. It pretty much had every gadget you could imagine, except for most part of the series, it wasn't electric proof. So one shock and it would be gone. So it's basically just a little hot air balloon they would use. It has Meowth clearly on the top of it because Meowth was their little comrade. And it does come with this little standee, which is inside of it. And I'm actually a little let down by this, just a little bit. He comes packaged, inside the balloon, no problem at all. You can see it on the outside of the box. But when you look at all the pictures, you see there's a little Meowth figure inside. Now, being that I'd only seen this online, I couldn't read all the fine print for it. But if you look on it, it is a one-figure set and figures not included. So it does seem kind of odd that they would have a Meowth figure inside of it in every single picture, yet there's not one included. It's kind of like, buy this figure and you can reenact this image. I'm not gonna buy a Meowth figure just to do it. I have my own plans for it. It would be nice to have a Meowth to go in it, but I'm definitely not worried. So here is the balloon itself, and it comes in a variety of pieces. Gonna go ahead and show what all is included. When you get it, it is kind of separated, but it comes with some connection rods, short and long, a missile launcher, a missile, a little rack, which is this part here. Hey, don't you get your mind out of the gutter. The basket, a one-piece net, the Meowth balloon tail, and the actual balloon. And then you pretty much assemble it all. And it all comes together rather nicely. It looks like it's one solid piece. It does have wheels in the bottom, so you can roll it around, although it looks like it only goes that way. So that's interesting. Look around the front here. Here is the missile launcher. It doesn't stay very securely, but being this will be hanging from the ceiling and not really getting much use, that's not a problem. It can rotate around. The missile does fire. And guard to the back here. And I know, see, missile came right off. I know someone's going to see this and freak out because I'm probably going to warp the hook, but there's a little grapple in the back that you can extend down, and that's where you can fix on the little net. It's a little rubber net. And it being rubber is pretty cool because you can actually stretch it around other figures. You can even stick like a figure's arm or leg through the actual net and have it kind of pose. And pretty much you would just loop one side. And of course, I'm not going to be able to do this because I was never good at sewing. Oh, there. Oh, see, I lost it. Let's do it the easy way, shall we? But you would pretty much take your little net, rope it through one side, and then through the other. And you would have this little thing. So you could put someone in there, carry them around, as if you captured a Pokemon, or a variety of other figures. And that's really about it. There's a launcher. Now, it doesn't really state this in the directions at all. And the directions are like really kind of complex. It's like, into the launcher, into the basket, into the projectile, into the launcher. Press the button to launch the projectile. I don't know why you really need that. It's not really that challenging. But it's not mentioned in the directions, but I do think that you can hook the little hook into the top of the missile. See, there's a little loop there. And it's kind of like if you would loop it through there, it's kind of like, just a grapple line, or since it is a little hand, if I remember correctly, this is the kind of hand they would use. They would kind of shoot it, or grab a Pokemon, pull it back. So you can do that. And then when you fire, see, I have to check the missile. Whee! And then it just kind of dangles. So you can do that. It doesn't really look that impressive. But you know what? A for effort. That's what I say. And go ahead and load that back in place. So there you go. Now, like I said, I have no Pokemon figures. I do have other plans for this. What plans might those be? Yes, I can take my 3 3/4 inch figures, and given I don't have a whole lot, but I do plan at some point to continue buying more of them. Get a few mixtures of Marvel, DC, Star Trek, Terminator, whatever I can really find, maybe even the G.I. Joe or two. And just having this displayed with, you know, an army of Terminators coming up the side. Yes, I'm going to try to find a few more of these for pretty cheap. Although the $10 price that I see online these days doesn't really work for me. But so you can see, it works with 3 3/4 inch figures. You can have them displayed in there. You know, it doesn't look that bad. And just, I figure having this hanging somewhere, having this going, it could bring up a few conversations. Maybe not the good kind, but could be a conversation starter. So there you go. There is your Meowth balloon from Pokemon Diamond and Pearl. Try to pick this up. I mean, it doesn't have a whole lot of play value. In my opinion, it's hollow. There's not really a whole lot to it. If you could find it on Amazon for the $8 price tag, or even eBay for $8, I would say go for it. It's worth it. 16 or more, you may be kind of pushing it, but it's pretty much all depending on what you really want to spend for it. But hope you guys enjoyed the video. Hope you have a great day, and I will see you around. Take care.